मैं हिंदी में पूछ सकता हूँ, परंतु कई लोग ऐसे हैं यहाँ जिनको हिंदी बिल्कुल नहीं आता. तो क्या क्या राय क्या बनी कि हिंदी में बोलूं या अंग्रेजी में बोलूं? हिंदी इंग्लिश. मैं आज हिंदू निशाने पर है इस सवाल पर अपने विचारों को रखने के लिए आया. I'm here basically to speak about the siege under which the Hindus are. And of course, I'm in North America because every summer I come to teach at Harvard University, from where I originally got my PhD. And then one incident after another woke me up to the dangers that the Hindu religion is facing. We do go to temples. There are now very large numbers of people going to temples in India also. Very happy to see so many temples in Toronto area. There are now 120 temples in the United States. Going to temples, doing puja, celebrating Diwali, Dasara, etc. These are, of course, great acts of discipline. But at the same time, we also owe a duty to defend the religion if it is threatened. There was a time when we were attacked physically by people who came from abroad. We fought them, but it took a long time to push them out. This time, the danger to the religion is much more sophisticated and much more subtle. It's not so open as when Ghori came or Ghazni came. And therefore, I would like to open your eyes to some of these developments.
Would have been another Kashmir. You know where Kashmir? Hindus are being driven out by the Muslims. He prevented another Kashmir in Tamil Nadu. Such is his love for liberty, and such is his fight against terrorism. And Sivaraju Swami has been the forefront in defending our beloved Shankaracharya of Kanchikam Kotipitam. When people in authority, they took law into their own hands, and for political purposes they put on flimsy charges, they could arrest a great sadhu of respect on Deepavali day. And when the Supreme Court heard the bail hearing, they said there is no case at all. And the government is authoritative in trying to impose jail sentences or arresting and all that on sadhus. So he was in the forefront exposing these governments. And I am very happy that he is here to talk to you all about this. And ladies and gentlemen, I am going to give Dr. Sivaraju Swami here.
It's unimaginable that a Shankaracharya could be arrested on a murder charge. People said, well, if such a charge is made, then the law must take its course. He was picked up on Diwali night, not in Tamil Nadu, where his mutt is, but in Andhra, brought midnight by road from Mehboob Nagar, presented before the magistrate's court at 4 a.m. in the morning without any sleep, and then put along with all other under trial murder accused in the Vellore jail. This has not been done to other people. For example, Sheikh Abdullah was accused of being betraying the country as a traitor. He was never kept in jail. He was kept in a guest house, and he had to cross the ocean, Bark Strait, and go to Sri Lanka and rescue his wife. And there was no bridge, so the Vanar Sena came and they put coral rocks which used to float, and so Ramchandraji wrote his name on every rock so it could sink. And today we find that there is a 1.5 mile wide causeway and 30 kilometer long causeway, from which if you come to Dhanushkodi, you can walk across to Sri Lanka. Over the years, this was in disuse, so the water is now above the causeway. Now the government of India decided that this Bark Strait, we should have commercial traffic going through it. And they found that the Bark Strait is too shallow, so this is decided to dredge a canal. In the dredging process, there were very many ways the canal could have been dug. There is a portion that juts out of India called the Rameshwaram Island, from Rameshwaram to Dhanushkodi. That piece of land, if you go through that, you cut through land, and then you can build a canal. Or you can go on the eastern side, and you run into the Rama Setu. And the government decided, instead of going through these alternative routes, they will go straight through the Rama Setu and destroy it. I went to court. The court has issued notice to the government asking why you have arbitrarily chosen the route which will destroy the Rama Setu. Why can't we choose another route? And on 31st August, the government has to give the reply, and I'm sure that we will win the case and Rama Setu will be protected. We ordinary people have to fight, because the government is not interested in fighting for you. So here again you find that in the religious side, whenever a question of Hindus come up, we are at a disadvantage. Why is that we are at a disadvantage? And especially from politicians who are also Hindus, because politicians want to win elections. And they find that Hindus are all divided amongst themselves, maybe by language, by religions, by caste. And finally, because the Sadhu Sons also protested in Hyderabad, led by Swami Dayanand Saraswati and Pejavaranath Swami, therefore, ultimately the government backed down and issued a new GO saying that all settlements belong to the Balaji Kriswara temple. Like this, you find that the government has enacted a law called Religious Endowments and Charitable Trust Act, which only applies to Hindu temples. And what does it empower the government to do? To take the money of the temples collected by the devotees. The devotees put in the hundi. The hundi is carried away by the government. A government officer is appointed for each temple. And only 6% of that money collected from the people, Hindu devotees, is spent on the premises. 94% is spent for Hajj subsidy, for building mosques, for madrasas, and so on. And this is in answer to a question in parliament. So this is not even something big secret that I am telling you. This is no sannyasi, a fooler. So today, if the foreigner comes to you wearing a sari and with a tikka, be very careful whether you are being fooled or not. I'm not naming any names. Now, so therefore, this history books are being written deliberately this way, to prepare your mind for changing, so that you decide your religion is not a virile religion, and therefore you should convert. When Shankaracharya was arrested, the Christian missionaries spread the word. Whatever, this is our, you say your government, you are a Hindu majority country, this has happened, no one can protect him. So therefore, psychologically also, there is this siege. So what should we do? It is wrong to say that all this is politics. It is not. In fact, whenever religion has been under threat, our seers, our rishis, they stood up and made people rise up to fight. But hatred for in Hinduism and that we have this problem that is created. Where the Parsis today, they came and became refugees in our country. We looked after them. Today there are Parsis who are judges of the Supreme Court. There are only 60,000 Parsis in India. But they are judges of the Supreme Court. The present Air Force Chief is a Parsi. The Attorney General of the last government was a Parsi. The biggest industrialist is Ratan Tata, Godrej, Chapanji Palanji, Nasri Wadia. So we are, there is no animosity to the Parsis, because the Parsis identify with the rest of Indian society. So they speak Gujarati, they wear Indian clothes, they totally speak only with their connection with India. But we find today doctors educated in our medical schools in Bangalore, they are going and trying to blow up Glasgow Airport. What for? If they are going and blowing up Glasgow Airport, not because the British came to India and looted India. So that I can understand. Okay, you got this fiery sentiment like Udham Singh and Bhagat Singh and others. But they are going and saying, because Americans are going to Iraq, so therefore we are going to blow up Glasgow Airport. What kind of mentality is this? It is this mentality we have to fight, and we can only fight if we are united. We are 83%, all 83% need not unite. 40% unites, you get absolute majority in the parliament. And you need a government in a democracy. Government is an important thing. It's the real battlefield. The Kurukshetra of democracy is the election. And there again, you should create the mindset. And then the country will be saved. Then your temples will be saved. Otherwise, what are you seeing today in Malaysia? Our temples are being demolished. Kazakhstan demolished. Moscow, Hare Ram, Hare Krishna's temple demolished. Trinidad temples have been defied. It won't be very long before they'll come in. Such activities start even here. So for that, you have to show a certain strength. We are a growing country today. We are a prospering country today. But prosperity is no guarantee that foreigners won't come and attack you. After all, we were the most developed country 1,000 years ago. And in these 1,000 years, when we have become poor, because at the most prosperous time of our history, foreigners came and took control of you because you were not united. So at this moment, this unity is necessary. The temples are not only forums for prayers, but also for resolve that you will defend Hinduism. This is what I wanted to say to you. Thank you very much for listening.
Saras, there is a war in my HUJ event, but the Nabar is 30 40 minutes later.
आपने तो बड़ा सुंदर तरीके से तो वैसे ही बता दिया है. वैसे मैं एकता के अतिरिक्त मैं समझता हूँ कि यहाँ संकल्प करना चाहिए कि हमारे देश में सारे लोगों को या यहाँ जो हैं भारतीय लोग हैं उनको एक भाषा में आपस में बात करने की वो व्यवस्था पैदा करने की जो चेष्टा है उसमें पहला कदम ये होना चाहिए कि हमारे बच्चों को या हमारे ग्रैंड चिल्ड्रन को संस्कृत सिखाया जाए. वो एक कदम जो बड़ी आसानी कदम है उस सरल कदम से जो आपको उस कनेक्शन चाहिए आपके अतीत काल से वो तुरंत मिल जाएगी. तो आप कुछ क्या करना है तो ये है. दूसरा है कि आपको जो भी यहाँ बाहर से आए उनसे आपको जब यहाँ संपर्क करते हैं या कहीं भी करते हैं तो उनको भी इस पर डिफेंसिव में डालनी चाहिए. उनको जवाब देने की मजबूर करनी चाहिए. उनको विवश करनी चाहिए कि वो जवाब दें कि जो हो रहा है इसका क्या उनके पास उत्तर है. आगे में हमारे देश में आतंकवाद हो रहा है उसके बारे में क्या करने वाले हैं. या हमारे हमारे संतों के साथ जो अपमान हो रहा है उसके लिए वो क्या करने वाले हैं। इस तरीके से आप करेंगे तो एक चेतना जगेगी। तो आपके व्यक्तिगत चेतना जगाने के लिए एक बात तो होनी चाहिए कि हम भले भले गुजराति हो या पंजाबी हो या तमिल हो, कुछ भी हो, लेकिन जहां देश खतरा के सवाल है, देश के सामने जो आपात उत्पन्न हो रही है, उसके लिए हम एक साथ रहेंगे। और दूसरा है उसके लिए हम अपना दान करेंगे, अपना योगदान करेंगे। और तीसरा कि हम जब भी ये मौका आएगी, एक शक्तिशाली और एक विराट सरकार बनाने की बात आएगी, तब हम हिंदू होकर के वोट डालने के लिए जो भी हम मदद कर सकेंगे तो करेंगे। ये मैं मोटे तौर पर यहाँ के बसे हुए लोगों को कहना चाहता
हूँ। धन्यवाद।
Abroad. We fought them, but took a long time to push them out. This time the danger to the religion is much more sophisticated and much more subtle. It's not so open as when Ghori came or Ghazni came. And therefore, I would like to open your eyes to some of these developments.
Would have been another Kashmir, you know, where Kashmir, Hindus are being driven out by the Muslims.
He apne vicharon ko rakhne ke liye aaya. I'm here basically to speak about the siege under which the Hindus are. And of course I'm in North America because every summer I come to teach at Harvard University, from where I originally got my PhD. And then one incident after another woke me up to the dangers that the Hindu religion is facing. We do go to temples.
मैं हिंदी में बोल सकता हूँ, परंतु कई लोग ऐसे हैं यहाँ जिनको हिंदी बिल्कुल नहीं आता।
तो
क्या राय क्या बनी कि हिंदी में बोलूं या अंग्रेजी में बोलूं? हिंदी
इंग्लिश मैं आज हिंदू निशाने पर है इस सवाल पर। There are now very large numbers of people going to temples in India also. Very happy to see so many temples in Toronto area. There are now 120 temples in the United States. Going to temples, doing puja, celebrating Diwali, Dasara, etc. These are of course great acts of discipline. But at the same time, we also owe a duty to defend the religion if it is threatened. There was a time when we were attacked physically by people who came.
Prevented another Kashmir in Tamil Nadu. Such is his love for liberty and such is his fight against terrorism. And Sarwar Insani has been the forefront in defending our beloved Shankaracharya of Kanchikana Gautipitam, when people in authority, they took law into their own hands and for political purposes, they put on flimsy charges